Do you wish that your meetings were more engaging? Are you tired of people not participating, even though you know that they have something to say? Well, in today's video, we're going to solve that problem by using Slido, a guaranteed way to make your meetings, whether they're in person or virtual, more engaging. Hello, everyone. Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And Slido is a tool that I use on a regular basis. So let's get started. Here's a quick example of what Slido can look like for your participants. Here I've set up a poll, and this is actually a poll I delivered recently, where I asked a question, sort of a great way to break the ice at the beginning of a presentation or something that you're delivering, whether it's a town hall or maybe a brainstorming meeting. And I asked my participants, hey, what are the most common sources of your interruptions? And this is what they said. And the great thing about it is that it's interactive and it's live, and your participants don't have to download or install anything. All they need to do is use their phone or other device that they may have with them and go to slido.com. So let's get started. Once you've signed up for your Slido account, what we need to do is come in here and we're going to select create an event. And a couple of things that we need to do here. Number one, let's give it an event name. Now you want to name it something that you're going to be familiar with, so you manage your different events here within Slido, but also keep in mind that this is something that your participants are going to see as well. So let's say I'm going to call this one a brainstorming session. I don't mind if they see that. Maybe you have a catchier title or something else that is relevant to your subject. Next up, we need to select a start and an end date. And you can see that many of these end dates are a few days out, because if you are hosting a conference or maybe you're holding several meetings over the course of several days, you want to use the same polls or ask the same questions or collect the same feedback. So you can either set the start and end date to the same date, or I'm just going to leave it as is here, from July 2nd to July 5th. And then the last thing we need to do here is either confirm this event code. It's going to give you a random number. This is how participants are going to access Slido so that they can participate. But I recommend that you use something custom. You use something that is very specific and also maybe simple for your users to remember. So in this case, I'm going to say brain. I don't know. That sounds a little funny to me. I'm just going to say brainstorm. Now, if someone else who uses Slido is going to be using this event code in the same time frame, it will not be made available. And Slido will tell you that up front. But it looks like I'm safe for these 3 days. I can use the event code brainstorm. Let's hit create event, and now we're ready to set up our event, whether that is setting up our Q&A or maybe asking some live questions, as in the poll that I just stated here. So here on the right-hand side, this is where our Q&A is going to be displayed, but why don't I show you what it's going to look like for your participants? Because I think this is the great thing about Slido, is that your participants can participate anonymously so that they can ask those questions that they might be a little embarrassed asking live and in person, or raising their hand, or if their username is attached to it if you're doing this via video conferencing. So I'm going to click try sending a question, and we're going to get this little preview here of what Slido will look like to your users on their phone. Now, typically, you'll have two different options here at the top, the Q&A, so that people can be asking questions throughout the presentation or throughout the brainstorming session, and then the polls over here. Now, we haven't set up a poll yet, but we're going to do that in just a moment. So let's pretend that we are a participant, and I'm going to say, when are we launching the next product, for example. Okay, now I have the option of adding my name here, but again, I find that the majority of people want to ask this anonymously, and as a presenter, I often encourage them to leave it anonymously. It encourages more feedback and often a lot more use of Slido throughout your session. So I'm going to hit send, and you can see that over here on the right-hand side, I can view the questions as they are coming in. And down below, not only will participants get to see their questions, but they'll get to see everyone else's questions as well. So let's say, let's ask a few more questions here. When is lunch? There's always going to be someone asking, when is the break, right? So we're going to ask another question there, and maybe something like, can we release these notes to our friends? something like that. Maybe it's something that someone's curious. Can we keep this under wraps, or can we share it with the public so they can see everything that is coming in here? I'm going to go over here to the right hand side and go into present mode, because this is what you are going to be sharing with your viewers, whether you're live in person or whether you're sharing via video conferencing. So here you can see it's listing the top three questions. I only have three questions in this particular case, but the great thing is that whether you're presenting this on a large screen in person or if you're sharing it via video conferencing, everyone gets to see what's sort of rising to the top. And what do I mean by that? Well, people can vote on these different questions. You can see there's a little thumbs up icon here. Now, we haven't upvoted anything here just yet, but if I go back to my preview, let's say that this one is most interesting to me, and maybe there's a few other people that are upvoting this one as well. If I go back to my view here, this is now at the top of the list, and this often encourages your participants to get more involved and to read other people's questions as well, especially since you can only display about 3 to 5 of the top questions on your screen. People want to try and upvote the things that they're most interested in, making sure that either you, the presenter, or maybe you're doing this for a guest speaker so that they can see what is most relevant to them. And what's helpful as a presenter or a moderator is as I hover over these questions, I can choose this little up arrow, which is going to automatically bring it to the top. Actually, let me do that with something else that maybe isn't at the top here. I'll do it for this question here. So it brings it to the top, it gives it a different color, and this just notifies my audience that this is the question that I am going to be answering right now. This is the question that I'm answering in the moment. And if I like, what I can do afterwards is I can hit this little check mark and it now removes that question. So now it goes back to the next order of questions on this list. So you don't always have to see questions that you've already answered in the past. But it gets better. As a moderator, not only do you get this preview view on your own smart device or this view if you happen to be managing this on your desktop, but what I love to do is that I will open up the Q&A very early on in my presentation, and then I can review these questions throughout. So I can see, I don't always show this screen, right? I might be showing my slides, I might be just showing my video as I'm talking or addressing the audience. I'm not showing this screen to the public, but I can preview all the questions that are coming in. And I've even adjusted my presentation on the fly in some cases as I see the feedback from the room. Even if it's a crowd that's too large that I haven't been able to hear from many people just yet, you can get a sense of what's going on. And the other great thing, as someone who is presenting or moderating this type of discussion, you can see what are the most relevant questions, right? What are people most concerned about? What are they worried about or excited about? And you can make sure you address those first and not just the person who is the quickest to raise their hand or just the person who can't seem to be quiet and keeps talking over everyone else. So a fantastic tool for engagement. But it doesn't stop there. Let's go over here to live polls and see if we can set up a live poll like I showed you right off the top. Now, there's a few different polls that we can create here. Multiple choice is a great icebreaker. It's very engaging. It's very easy for people to use, right? Because they don't have to enter in any text. But there's some other good ones you want to keep in mind as well. You can create a word cloud. This is great if you're asking a question such as, you know, in one word, how would you describe this? Or in one word, how would you describe how you're feeling today? The reason why I suggest using the one word for the word cloud is that, of course, the answers that are given multiple times are going to grow and they're going to show bigger, like we see here in this example with clear goals. You can add a quiz, which is relatively new here within Slido. You can add a rating, you know, out of 4 stars or out of 10 stars. How are you feeling today? Another great icebreaker. And you can also just do open text, which is similar to Q&A, although you can't vote on these ones. So this is more just sort of bubble text that will be appearing. But probably the one I use the most often with my meetings and with my presentations is multiple choice. Now, it's fairly straightforward, but let's just go through the different features, the different options here, so you can create your own multiple choice questions like a pro. So, multiple choice. Let's say, let's do something very, very easy here. Let's say, what is your favorite pet? Okay, we'll say, what is your favorite pet? And of course, we gotta give a few different options here. So I'm gonna say dog, cat, I'm gonna say fish, maybe, and let's say other, right? Let's give another other option as well. Now, there's a few other choices here. We can say mark the correct answer if this is more of a quiz format, right? If you want to try and see, maybe you wanna test your audience halfway through or partway through your presentation. Have they been listening? Give them a multiple choice question and see if they can guess the correct answer. I'm going to leave this one unchecked for now, but the one below can be very helpful depending on what you want to have your participants' feedback with here. Do you want to allow multiple options? Now, by default, this is going to be unchecked, but you can check this and then also set a limit. So this can be great if you want to maybe ask a question like, what are your two favorite pets? Or what are your two most favorite or three most favorite? And then you can say what that limit is so that they can't choose more than that. I'm going to uncheck it in this particular case. I just want them to pick a particular option here. And all I need to do now is hit save. So now my multiple choice is ready to go. By default, my Q&A is going to be the thing that is presented when I go into this presentation view. And as I mentioned before, your participants will never have to worry where they need to go, whether they have a phone, any device with a web browser, just go to slido.com. And here is going to be the event code listed right below. But let's say I want to ask this multiple choice question. So in the administrator view on my phone or here within the desktop version, I just need to hit play. And by hitting play, the right side of my screen is going to showcase this. But you'll see if I go back to the presentation view, it is now going to show the poll. It's going to switch over from the Q&A and show my poll. And the great thing about it is that you can see if the majority of people are coming into the poll because this little ticker in the right-hand side, you can see over here, if I go to my first example, I had 19 people participate in this poll. This ticker will go up live. So you can tell if people are having trouble. You can tell if the majority of the room or the majority of your audience is coming in or not. But the other great thing is that this poll is dynamic. So as people start to vote, these bars will start to expand or get smaller depending on what is most popular. And I find time and time again, people really, really enjoy this. When I use Slido at a conference or in a live situation, people are often laughing. They're having a good time. Sometimes they change their decision based on what they see up here. It's often a fight to the end. You know, is dog going to win? Is cat going to win? And it comes right down as a nail biter. People really, really enjoy the engagement level here with Slido. Now, if you want to make your online meetings more engaging, I would encourage you to view my video on how to use breakout rooms in Zoom. It's a fantastic way to get the conversation going. Or you can click the video to the right to watch the latest video right here on Simpletivity. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.